So section 9.1 was talking about all, what was the language? Levy is on all intrastate supply of goods and services or both. Yes or no? Excluding alcoholic liquor for human consumption. Third point was valuation shall be done by section 15. Tax rate will be given by government on recommendation of council, not exceeding 20%. It should be paid by taxable person and collection should happen as prescribed. This is 9.1. 9.2 was simple 5 petroleum product on which we don't have any levy as of now. It will be there in future. Therefore, we are starting with 9.3. Concept number 7 is actually 9.3, extension of 9.3. What I told you in extension of 9.3 that there are certain goods and services on which we are having reverse charge mechanism. These are the services, list of services on which we are having reverse charge mechanism. Alright. So there are total 14 entries. Technically there are 16 entries, but number wise there are 14 because we are having 5A, 5CA, 5, so you know, because of that number is 14. Okay, because 5 has 3 different versions, 5A, 5B and 5C. Therefore, it is extended to 16 to 17. But technically, we are going to discuss 14 entries of reverse charge mechanism. The moment I say reverse charge mechanism, who will be liable to pay tax? Supplier or recipient? In reverse charge, who will pay tax?
Recipient.
Why? What is the logic behind it? So I told you collection of tax from supplier might become little difficult or troublesome for the government of India. So they are putting them into reverse charge mechanism. By default, if your name is not in reverse charge, then by default you are in forward charge. Yes or no? So we cannot by heart who is in forward charge because everybody is in forward charge. So we can by heart what? Who is in reverse charge? Yes or no? So therefore we are discussing reverse charge mechanism. The first point of reverse charge mechanism, okay, it is given in which notification? Notification number 13/2017. This notification you need to remember, and here tax will be paid by recipient. Alright. So the first point is services of GTA. Now on GTA we will be discussing things in detail. There will be extra note in your module for GTA. Okay, so here we are not discussing GTA in much detail. Some of the points of this reverse charge mechanism we are going to discuss in much more detail in some other chapter like exemption and all. Here we are just understanding that GTA doesn't pay tax. Okay, now who is the GTA? GTA is a goods transport agent. Technically they are truck drivers and all. Okay, now truck driver is providing services to factory. So there are 100 truck drivers. I have contract with 100 truck driver. I'm like Maruti Suzuki. I manufacture car, and because I have to deliver car in different parts of the city, and in fact different cities altogether, I have tie up with 100 truck, different truck contractors. Now by looking at truck contractor, you can understand it will be very difficult for them to comply with the law. Yes or no? Because they are not that highly professional kind of people. So what government have said, whenever GTA provides services to registered person, to any registered person. So there is a list of registered person, and that list we have to read from module. Here because we are writing summary, I'm writing like this. GTA providing services of transportation of goods to any registered person. Registered person means either it can be company, partnership firm, factory, cooperative, society. So this there is a list of registered person. So who will pay tax? Registered person will pay tax. This is a supplier and that is a recipient. Yes or no? Supplier providing services to recipient, instead of GTA, Maruti Suzuki will pay tax. Yes or no? It's easy for government to collect tax from registered person than GTA. Am I clear? And because these people are not highly qualified, they are not having any fear of law. Technically, government is unable to threat, you know, provide them any threat or, you know, put pressure on them because they don't care about law. See, only people who is having fear about law, person who understand law. These people don't understand law, therefore they don't carry any fear of default. Am I clear? Therefore, they could have done default, and so many things have happened. There's a background to GTA. So GTA we will discuss in detail when GTA points come. So there will be particular dedicated lecture, half an hour lecture for GTA. Am I clear? Here you just understand, whenever GTA is liable to pay tax, it will be paid by recipient, not GTA. Am I clear? Goods transport agent. It will be paid by a registered person. Second, advocate. Now, GST law has given so much of favor to advocates also. Okay. So many services providing, in fact, majority services provided by advocates are exempt. Do you understand exempt means what? They don't have to pay tax. Majority services are exempt. Only certain services provided by advocate, and that too business entity, that too business entity like company, partnership, from some commercial entity. Alright, so that is taxable. And there also what government have done, they are not putting burden on advocate. to comply with the law, the burden is on business entity. So tomorrow XYZ Private Limited is taking services from advocate. Advocate is a supplier of service, yes or no? But advocate is not required to pay tax and all. Everything will be done by business entity. Again, why? Because maybe collection of tax from advocates would have become very difficult. We trust business entity over advocate, therefore there is a reverse charge mechanism. Something like this you can keep in mind, although there is no logic behind it. If this is in reverse charge mechanism, then we have to follow that this is in reverse charge mechanism. You should not try to find logics behind every point, and technically we don't have time also to go into in depth, but still this point will come again. Advocate services are there in exemption, so we will discuss there in detail. Advocates, am I clear? So who pay tax on advocates? So business entity. Next point, like advocates, we are having arbitral tribunals. Okay, what is job of tribunals or arbitral tribunals? So certain matters we don't want to take to courts. All right, so like if I have contract with Dilip sir for completion of your batch, and there is a x consideration fixed for x number of hours, all right, and if there is a dispute between we both, all right, I don't want to take my case to district high court or district court or high court or supreme court. I don't want to go there because that is going to take too much of time, energy, you understand? I don't want to go there. I just wanted to go and meet one person on which I can rely, Dilip sir also can rely, and that guy may be acting as an arbitral tribunal. He will listen both cases, he will settle the case. Yes or no? And he will take fees from both of us. Okay. Now, like advocate is exempt. He is also providing similar type of service, not exactly same, but similar type of service. Okay. So, similar exemptions are given to the exemptions which are available to advocate. Similar exemptions are also available to this arbitral tribunal. And arbitral tribunal also doesn't pay tax. Who will pay tax? Business entity. Like in advocate case, who is paying tax? Business entity. In advocate also, who will be paying tax? Business entity. All right. Then sponsorship, you must have gone on some, you know, Dahi Handi festival or Ganesha festival, alright, where they put lot of banners, like in Mumbai we are having 10 days Ganesha, so Ganesha will be there after 1 kilometer, balance 1 kilometer you see lot of boards, no holdings, alright, so who are they? They are sponsorship. In cricket also, in cricket match and all, you must have seen, they have on bat MRF written or T-shirt is there, Videocon or some companies. You know, what is this sponsorship? What is this sponsorship? So if you give sponsorship, that means if you give money to us as an organization, you give money to us. We are conducting some event, maybe, you know, one day marathon or one day sport activity or maybe 10 days Ganesha activity or maybe annual day, you know. So we are going to conduct, we are organizers of event, we are conducting event, you give sponsorship. So tomorrow you as the institution, if you give sponsorship, what will happen? When we are going to conduct event, we will put your banner, right? And in most of the these awards and all, you must have seen, no, IFA awards and Filmfare awards, they say no, some name they will take, Paytm presents or this presents, you know, as sponsored by, yeah, co-sponsored by. So these words come. So this is a sponsorship service. Now this event management company, they will conduct event and they will go away. Now in next year or next month, we cannot stress them because they are just a short term event. But the sponsored company, the company which has given sponsor, like MRF, like Videocon, like Vodafone, hello, they cannot run, they are still there. You understand? So there is an advertisement agency, this is sponsorship, okay, and then there is a company for which we are doing sponsorship, okay. You as a government have reliance more on whom? Event organizing company or company for which this sponsorship was provided, or this advertisement company like MRF. So one is your cricket team, you will play for 7 days and you will go. And then there is a, while playing cricket for 7 days, you are wearing t-shirt of Videocon. Yes. Are you getting? So from government point of, you are a supplier of service, no? You are advertising for, your advertising agency for Videocon. Are you getting this?
Yes.
So government can collect taxes easily from whom? Event management or Videocon?
Videocon,
because that is a business entity, established entity, that will not run away. Event management company will conduct event. And in Mumbai, we are having, you know, Dahi Handi, this Govinda festival, one day festival. So many organizations are there, so many, you know, youth, these committees are there, they conduct this one day. In one day they will conduct, and tomorrow they will become normal people. Yes or no? Ganesha 10 days, in 10 days everything happens, everything closed down. Now nobody is there. Hello, who will look after tax compliance and all? Therefore, government said in sponsorship service, tax will be paid by body, corporates or partnership firm. Please understand, if it is given to any other entity like proprietorship firm, or any other business, small business entity, then it is not taxable. It is not under reverse charge mechanism. Reverse charge mechanism is applicable only when it is provided to body, corporate or partnership firm. To be very precise, what is the difference between this and this? Here all business entity comes. Even the proprietorship comes. Here only body corporates, like company, corporates that comes, and partnership firm. Am I clear? So this is up to four. Up to four it is clear? I'm repeating once more. First was GTA to business registered person. GTA to the registered person will pay tax. Second, advocate to business entity. The business entity will pay tax. Third, arbitral tribunal to business entity. Business entity will pay tax. Sponsorship service, sponsors to body corporate or partnership firm. Body corporate and partnership firm will pay tax. Am I clear?
Yes.
Can you just turn here and light? Just first button, yeah. So here we are having balance points. Okay. Point number five here we are having government services. This is also very detailed point. Okay. More than half an hour. I'm not even sure about half an hour. More than half an hour we are going to invest into this point. Point number five. Where central government state, yesterday also I told you, like in the definition of person, even government is included. Yes or no? That means even government pays tax. And when I say government pays tax, it means it's like taking money from this pocket and putting money in this pocket, because government paying tax to government. GST is collected by government and taxpayer is also government. Alright, so there is a logic, very good logic behind it, and so many services of government services are actually exempt. So we are going to discuss this government services point again in exemption, but whatever is taxable, some services are taxable. 99% services are exempt, 1% services are taxable, and that too taxable on reverse charge basis. Are you getting this?
Yes.
It is taxable, that too taxable on reverse charge basis. But point number five have exclusion, two exclusion. Okay, renting of immobile property and specified service. Now this specified service is given in entry six of exemption. There I will teach you entry six of exemption. So that I will teach you later on. Right now you need to focus on this government services. If it is provided to business entity and if it is taxable, 99% it is not taxable, only 1% it is taxable. So government will not pay tax. Who will pay tax?
Business
entity will pay tax. Here, because the renting of immobile property was excluded, last year by amending the law, they have also covered renting of immobile property also. Alright, so till last year renting of immobile property was under forward charge. So if I take to conduct this class, if I take government hall, I'm a business entity. If I take government hall on rent, I'll be paying rent?
Yes.
Yes or no? And government was liable to pay tax to government. Yes or no?
Yes.
Till last year, this was the situation. Last year, they amended the law. And now even renting of immobile property is also covered under reverse charge. So you can understand from point number five, renting is excluded.
Yes.
That means we feel renting is in forward charge.
Yes.
By reading point number 5 you feel, because it is excluded from reverse charge, something which is excluded from reverse charge will be under forward charge. So here point number 5, renting is excluded, but point number 5A covers renting of immobile property, because this was later amendment. And then why instead of amending, why they just didn't delete it? If they delete this exclusion, then by default it was in reverse charge. No, because here it is only business entity, here it is only, and here it is any. There is a slight difference between this, okay? Any business entity and any register. So this is little wider than a business entity. Alright, more people get covered here in this reverse charge. Okay? Yeah? Can I go ahead? So these are the two points which are in relation to government. Point number 5B and 5C, again have a lot of discussion over it. But please understand, whenever you are a landowner, and you are giving your land in Mumbai, a lot of redevelopment projects are going on. Alright, society redevelopment, slum redevelopment. So you are a land owner, okay, and you are giving your land to some builder to construct building. You are not selling your land. you are allowing him to construct building, and once this building gets ready, you will sell, like some part of the building you will sell and some part of the building builder will sell. You will recover your cost of land and builder will recover his cost of construction. Hello, this is a joint development agreement, JDA. This is something called as joint development agreement. So here land owners don't pay tax, builder pays tax. Who pays tax?
Builder.
Builders. So promoter means builder. Promoter means actually builder. Promoter means builder. So either you will transfer TDR, development rights, or FSI, floor space index. Again, it is the real estate industry, very technical. We are having detailed notes, this chart on that. Okay, but here please understand, land owner will not pay tax. Who will pay tax?
Builder.
So reverse charge mechanism. Here I wanted to tell you only one thing, that there are 14 items on which we are having reverse charge mechanism. Okay, next. Directors. Now in India we are having more companies or more number of directors? Quantity wise, every company will have minimum 2 directors.
Yes.
Unlisted company will have 5 to 7 directors, 10 directors, 20 directors, sometimes directors number will be more. And directors are individuals, yes or no?
Yes.
And then there are companies. Directors are providing services to company. You tell me, collection of tax will be easier from?
Body
corporate company. Therefore, directors are providing their directorship services to body corporate. Who is paying taxes?
Body
corporate. Similarly, insurance agents are more. LIC example I already told you. Alright, insurance agent providing agency services to insurance company. Who will pay tax?
Insurance
company. Okay. Similarly, we are having bank recovery agent. When bank recovery agent will come to your house? When will he come to your house? If you have taken loan and you are not repaying that loan, so recovery agent will come. Bank cannot come. Bank employee cannot come because banks are like professional people. Okay. Recovery agent means gunda people. Hello. Therefore, bank gives this. No, seriously, because they have to abuse you, they have to hit you sometimes. Hello. They have to insult you, humiliate you on, in your organization. But if bank does this, then it doesn't look good. So what bank smartly do this, this job is given to outsource agency. Yes or no? Outsourcing. This is what? Outsourcing. So these private agents will come. Some local gunda in Jogeshwari, he will get that contract. And he is a responsibility, Jogeshwari East or this Mumbai, this division. Okay, this guy will come and he will collect money for ICICI Bank or SBI Bank. So they take recovery agency. Am I clear? Now you tell me, is it easy to recover tax from recovery agent? No. First of all, they are gunda. Secondly, they are too many people. Alright. And then they are not professional one. Okay. So recovery agent is providing services to bank or financial institution or non-banking financial corporation, like different versions of banking industry. So who will be paying tax?
Bank.
Okay. Till here, please understand, till here, how many items are covered? Till here, how many agents are covered? Insurance agent, recovery agent, and two more items I will teach you. Okay. Subject to it is there in your syllabus. Okay. There is something called business correspondence and business facilitators. If it is there in your syllabus, then I will teach you. I have to check from your module. Okay. So one more agent will come in banking company, business corresponding agent. Okay. So there are three agents now. Point number 9 is author or composer or photographer or artist. Okay. So T-Series is a music company.
Yes.
And there are hundreds of singers singing for T-Series. Yes or no? All right. There will be one, you know, in Maharashtra we are having that publication, Manan publication or some publication for BCom, they write books. All right, so many authors are writing for one publication house. So you tell me, recovery of tax will be easier from whom? Publication house or those authors and singers? Publication house. So therefore, publishers, music company, producers, etc. So we are collecting taxes from them. 5 more item will come. Okay, but that I have to write on board. Till that time, you will please finish writing up to here.